is on assessment of plate waste in Base Hospital Varakapala. The presenters are Dr. SMNSM Mallavarachi, Dr. CH Mallavarachi, and Dr. KCS Dalpatadu. The paper will be presented by Dr. SMNSM Mallavarachi.
Thank you, sir. Good afternoon, everyone. As you all know, the hospital diet is provided free of charge for all the patients who are hospitalized during their stay in our government sector hospitals. But if all the food ordered for the patient is not consumed by them, that gives rise to considerable food waste in the hospital diet service. Here, the food waste could lead to considerable financial loss to the system, and it could also challenge the optimum nutrition of patients. The aim of our study was to assess plate waste in a base hospital in Varakapola. The plate waste we took as the number of portions not consumed by the patients once it is ordered. It was a cross-sectional study, and this was conducted in year 2019 in Base Hospital Varakapola in Kegal district, which is a secondary care hospital. During the study, desk review of diet ordering book and the kitchen records were carried out to ascertain the number of plates ordered. And a checklist was used to assess the number of food plates which was not consumed by the patients once it has been ordered. Interviewer administered questionnaire was used to ascertain the patient's factors and their satisfaction regarding selected attributes of hospital food. And key informant interviews with the main staff members involved in the diet service was assessed. We came to know that the plate waste in the hospital in a randomly selected month in year 2019 was 24.9, which was actually 1/4 of the total food service. It was seen regarding the diet menus, those menus were mainly prepared by the diet clerk with minimum contribution from the medical officers or nursing officers. And the menus were poor in variety and was not appealing to the patients. And actually, the patients never knew what was to be served until it was served. The menus were not displayed in advance. Regarding the diet estimation process, the requirement estimation, the diet clerk used to visit each ward daily, scan the whole bed day ticket, the paper-based medical record in our system, and tick off the number of diets needed. The communication between the ward staff and the diet clerk during this process was minimum, and it was never sought whether the patient was a vegetarian or a non-vegetarian person. And as a matter of fact, it was seen that when you calculate the requirement for a given day, it was generally assumed that all who required food required all three meals. Further, the food was not served at the bedside. The patient or the bystander had to walk to the food trolley and get it. And tea and soup were served with the main meals. And the dinner was served very early. That was 4 to 5 p.m. It was seen, we analyzed the patient's choice whether they required hospital food or home food during their stay, and it was seen majority of people, 81%, required both home food and hospital food during their stay, and only 10% had expected meals from hospital only. 9% had selected home food only. And from those patients who requested hospital food, we saw that it was only 12% of patients actually needed all three meals from the day from hospital. Majority required only two meals. Regarding the patient satisfaction regarding what selected attributes of hospital diet, we saw that timeliness of serving food was not really satisfactory to the patient. Only 56% said it was all right, but they were satisfied. 72% were satisfied regarding the cleanliness of food handling when it was served. And 76% of patients thought the hospitality of the staff when serving food was all right. But only 50% was satisfied with the general presentation or the appearance of food. Regarding the other factors, taste, aroma, and the freshness of food was generally accepted all right by the patients, above 80%. So in conclusion, the factors which would create this plate waste are, first thing is wrong estimations, poor timing of servings, and less organized diet service process, and poor responsiveness to patients' factors in this system, and lack of staff training. So we'd like to recommend the improvement of food requirement estimation, especially to calculate by meal-wise, and revision of menus with more participation with clinical staff members, and a kind of arranging a mechanism to display menus in advance for the patients, and improving the food serving process and timing, and introducing a mechanism to obtain patients' preferences of meals, and in-service training for staff. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Mallava Arachchi. We have about 3 minutes for any questions before you have your diet today.
So, do you think that this is the case in other hospitals also? I mean, what is the literature say?
Actually, very few. This is mostly overlooked area in our hospital management. Very few studies has been done regarding hospital diet, especially this plate waste. In one study, which was not really published, which was conducted by a dietitian, it has they have found that more than 20, my finding was 25, almost 25%, but their findings, it was 40% the wastage was, which could explain by the fact that we were going by the plate waste. So there could be any other factors contributing, and the real picture would be somewhat more than this.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Mallava Arachchi. That brings us to the end of this session. I thank all the speakers and all the colleagues who presented the papers, and I sincerely thank the audience. Thank you.